Hey everyone, welcome back to another video. I'm Usman and today I'll be starting a brand new series of building a to-do app with vanilla JavaScript. Now this is not just a normal to-do app tutorial. I already have a tutorial about to-do list app that I built with React and Material UI, but that was very basic. This is not very basic. This is built with HTML, JavaScript, Tailwind CSS, and local storage, so all your to-dos are being persisted. And this does not include the simple features like adding a to-do and deleting a to-do. It also has the editing feature, which is quite a lot requested and it's very difficult to implement at first. So let me show you a demo, because it's better to show rather than tell everything. So this is how you can add a to-do. Let's say I want to meet with boss, okay? And if I hit enter, or if I click on this add button, it's just going to add a to-do right over there. Now this is how the to-do interface looks like. It has the delete button right over here. It has the edit button. If we click on the edit, say maybe I put boss by mistake right over there and I have to meet with an old friend. So if I just edit that and look at it, it's not add now, it's called save. So if I click on it or press the enter button, it's going to edit that to-do as well. You can check the to-do if it's done. You can uncheck it if it's not done. You can delete it. But before deleting, let's take a look. If I refresh the page, it still stays. If I check it and I refresh the page, it says checked. If I delete the to-do and then refresh, there are no to-dos. So everything is stored in local storage, because if you build a to-do app normally without local storage, it has no memory. It will just create to-dos and when you refresh, it's gone. So we are using local storage to persist to-dos. Now, if you are very new to local storage, don't worry, I'll guide you through it. I also have a video on it about a project that you can check out up top. So in this video, we are going to just set up the project. Now the prerequisites to this is HTML and some basic knowledge of Tailwind CSS and the knowledge of JavaScript. So first you will need Node.js installed in your computer. Why? Because we are using Tailwind CSS, we have to install and set that up. So just go ahead and download the LTS or the current version, any of these versions, from nodejs.org. I'll leave this link in the description below. Even if you don't understand it, just download and install it. It's a simple software for now. Now once you have Node.js installed on your computer, what you can simply do is just open a folder inside of VS Code of your choice. Select folder and that's going to open that up. Now once you have the folder open, it's going to be empty for now. What you can do is you can just go right over here and open the terminal and open the new terminal right over here, because we are going to generate a new Vite app. Now if you don't know what Vite is, it's a simple app generator with which you can manage dependencies, you can manage all the stuff that Tailwind generates. So Tailwind will give you some generated CSS. Now if you don't want to use Tailwind, if you want to use normal CSS, just go with that. So we are using Tailwind, we are going to create a new app with Vite. So you can just run the command called npm create Vite dot. So this is the command that we are going to run. So you have to select a framework. Now we are not using any other framework, we are just using vanilla JavaScript. So just go ahead and select vanilla and JavaScript. Once that's done, you will get a lot of files in here. Now we don't need most of them. So let's go ahead and clean this up a little bit. We don't need the counter.js. We don't need the javascript.svg. I guess that's all we don't need. So let's delete both of these. And if I go to main.js, there's a lot of boilerplate code in here. So let's just get rid of everything, because we don't need that. Except for the style CSS import, because that is something we will need. So if I go to style CSS, we also don't need anything in there. If I go to index.html, let's just rename this to to-do app. And that's basically it. We can also remove this div id app. So once all this is set up, let's go ahead and follow these steps. So you have to run npm install right now. So let's just say npm install, just that, nothing else. That's going to install all the dependencies. Now let's hop on to the Tailwind website and I'll show you how you can use the docs to easily set up Tailwind in your project. So if I just go to get started, and we are using Vite, as I said. So you can go to framework guides and Vite. So we can just select this one. So this is how they show, okay, you're using the template for React. We are not using the template for React. We're using the vanilla template. So let's go on to the next step where we have to install this. So let's go ahead and copy this and paste it right over here and then hit enter. Now let that install. We can just go ahead and copy this one and then paste this one right over here. So this command is just going to create the configuration files for Tailwind and post CSS. Now you can just go ahead and copy all this and then just paste it inside of the Tailwind config CJS. Basically, this is how you will tell Tailwind, okay, which file will be using the Tailwind CSS. So right now the index.html, yes, that, and then inside of the source folder, every JS, TS, JSX, TSS, TSX file. But that's not the case here. So what we can do is we can just get rid of all of these because we are only using vanilla JavaScript. So we can just keep only JS and then it's inside of the source folder. So let's go ahead and create a new SRC folder and just move the main JS right there. And then we can just go back to index.html. This is how it points to index it, main JS. So let's just say source/main.js. All right. So hopefully we are done with it. Let's give it a shot. I'm just going to say H1. Oh, sorry. I forgot just one step. So going back to docs, this is what we have to add in our CSS file. Let's copy this and go back to style CSS and simply paste it. That's all we need. So now if I go back in here, I'll just say H1, hello, Tailwind. And let's give it some classes. So class text. text2xl, text gray 500. All right, let's see how that goes. Now, instead of going live with the live server that you might have used before, we are going to open up the terminal once again. And this is, and I'm using the shortcut called control backtick for that. We can just open the terminal and we can say npm run dev. So let's hit that. That's going to start a local development server. It's just like live server, so don't worry about that. And let's open this up. Okay, so this error says, hey, you cannot import style CSS from source main.js. So we moved the main.js right inside of the SRC folder. What we have to do is just point to ./style.css. Going back, this is how it looks like. We got Tailwind up and running. Now we are not just using Tailwind. We are also using Flowbite, which is kind of an extension to Tailwind. It has a lot more features. So we could just go ahead and hit get started. And all we have to do is just install Flowbite and then just require the plugin. So let's do that real quick. Go back to the terminal. Let's stop this and let's say, well, hey, npm install Flowbite. And then just go ahead and copy this. And then we'll go inside of Tailwind config, go to plugins and paste it right over here. All right, so that's basically it. We don't need to do anything else. Let's start the server once more and let's cross check if that works. So Tailwind right over here tells us that this is invalid. Instead, use this pattern. So let's copy this and let's just paste it right over here. Pretty cool. All right, fine. Let's go back and it works just as fine. You might see a little glitch, which means that the CSS is not loaded properly. This won't be the case in production. So this is the production version, and if you refresh this one, you won't see that in this case. You will only see that in the development case. So you don't need to worry about that at all. So in the next video, we are going to just try to build the UI as much as we can. I hope you enjoyed this. Leave a like, comment below what are your thoughts on this and your suggestions and feedback. And finally, thanks for watching.